big drink here. Next question is going to be from Michael Vander Galen. Wow. All right. Michael, personally, I am constantly challenged when it comes to rewiring my brain. I'm trying it, enjoying it, but it's like an addiction. Somehow my mind wants to go back to the old way and even objects to new ways. How do you cope with that? How do you deal with old thought patterns and fears when they pop up? Ignore them, squash them, reason it out. So to me, I really am a slave to my goals. And that's a really important thing to understand about me is I am always working backwards from what do I need to do to achieve my goals. And so one, I recognize that the reason that you're finding that your mind, it's like an addiction, it's going back is a process called myelination. So your brain is very used to the negative thoughts. It's used to the old way of thinking. And so it's actually connected those regions of your brain into a network through myelination, which is a fatty tissue that it wraps around the connection points between the neurons so that the electricity can signal faster so that you actually become more efficient in thinking that way. It's why the process of gaining mastery works. So I understand that about my brain, and I understand that trying to tear that down isn't the right idea. Trying to build something new up, build a new network, that's the way that you want to go about it. So I know, okay, it's going to take time, and I'm not going to focus on the negative loops. I'm going to focus on reinforcing the positive loops. And one of the ways that I've gotten very effective at this is when I get into a negative loop, what I do is I let that be a habit trigger to trigger the new way of thinking. So my old way of thinking, rather than lamenting it or going down that path, as soon as I realize that I'm having those thoughts, I immediately let that trigger the new way of thinking, the new habit loop. At the beginning, that's inefficient, and then it grows more efficient over time. So instead of trying to silence the negative voice in my head, I use it as a habit loop trigger. Also, I find that the negative voice in my head alerts me to something. In fact, this is important. The negative voice isn't necessarily wrong. It just has its scale off. So it's trying to tell you that something is like some huge deal, and it's going to cause like the downfall of Western civilization. That's where that negative voice goes, or it says you're a bad person or whatever. So I go, okay, your scale is way the fuck off, but you may actually have a point, and I may need to take that seriously. So for instance, I still get anxious before every episode of Impact Theory that I do, but I use that anxiety to remind myself I need to know more about this than even that person's mother. I need to research, I need to do the work. So as it's getting late and I really want to do something else, like go and like comment on Facebook or YouTube, which is a lot more fun than, you know, doing the hard work, writing the intro, or writing the intro, I really want to slack off on that. But I know that in writing the intro, I really figure out who that guest is, and so it's worth that whole process. So just understanding that the negative voice is useful, that it can be a habit loop trigger, and that while its scale is off, it actually may be pointing out something real that you need to pay attention to. So that's what I do with that stuff. All right.